Welcome to this tutorial on multi-factor authentication on Oracle Cloud. Multi-factor authentication provides an additional layer of security by requiring users to provide a second factor, such as a code sent to a phone, in addition to a password. So, what is covered in the video? How to regain access when you have been locked out, and how to manage and set up multi-factor authentication on new domains. Let's start with how to get support when you're locked out. For paid customers. Follow current support process for paid customers to get support for multi-factor authentication. Raise a service request via the MOS support page or by calling support. Be aware that they will need a CSI number. Now, for always free, this will be this process. Let's start with the landing page view. Click on the chat function at the bottom right-hand side of the page. In the pop-up, select the Cloud Support Chat by selecting Start Chat. Select your country or region. Enter now your email address. Select the first option in this list. And then click on Start Chat. Send a chat message saying Agent, and then click on Chat with a live agent. Once the agent is with you, ask them to assist you in unlocking your account. They will guide you from this point forward. We will now set up multi-factor authentication for accounts using identity domains. From the hamburger menu, select Identity and Security, and then Domains. Once the list of your available domains appears, click on the domain you want to configure. From the menu, select Security, and then Multi-Factor Authentication. This is the place where we only configure the possible authentication methods, but be aware, this does not enable multi-factor authentication. To enable it, we have to go to the Sign-on Policies menu entry and create a new policy. Enter a name and then click Add Policy. Now let's add a new sign-on rule for our brand new policy. Click Add Sign-on Rule. Here is where all the magic happens. Enter a name for our rule first, then enter or select all identity providers that will be used to authenticate the user accounts evaluated by this rule. Use the group membership option to enable multi-factor authentication for all users by entering or selecting the groups that users must be a member of to meet the criteria of this rule. Then be sure Allow Access is checked. This will ensure a user will be allowed to access the console if the user account meets the criteria of this rule. Select the Prompt for Reauthentication checkbox to force the user to re-enter credentials to access the assigned application, even when there's an existing identity domain session. Select the Prompt for an Additional Factor checkbox to prompt the user for an additional factor to sign into the identity domain. Select Mobile App Passcode, and, while testing, every time as the desired frequency. Save TE rule by clicking on the Add Sign-on Rule button. Click Next to go to the last step, adding the console app to the scope of the policy. Click Add App and select OCI Console. Click Close to finish saving our new policy. Now, we have our policy, but it's not yet active. The only thing we have to do is to click the Activate Sign-on Policy button at the top. And we're done. Now, let's test it by logging out and logging back in with a user belonging to our identity domain. The first time they're logging in, the user will be prompted to enable the multi-factor authentication device. Here, we could use either the Oracle Mobile Authenticator app, you will find the link in the description, or any other authentication app available. It worked. Multi-factor authentication is now enabled.